This lesson will demonstrate the use of Chebyshev's theorem and also introduce the idea of the empirical rule. Chebyshev's theorem is used in a distribution of any kind of shape to find the percent of data that falls within a certain range. The empirical rule must have a bell-shaped distribution or symmetrical normal distribution shape. We've already seen that the variance and standard deviation of a variable can be used to determine the spread of the variable. The larger the variance or standard deviation, the more the data values vary from the mean. For example, if two variables measured in the same units have the same mean, and variable 1 has a standard deviation of 1.5, while variable 2 has a standard deviation of 4, then the data for variable 2 will be more spread out than the data for variable 1. Chebyshev's theorem specifies the proportions of the spread in terms of the standard deviation. His theorem states that the proportion of values from a data set that will fall within k standard deviations of the mean will be at least 1 minus 1 over k squared, where k is a number greater than 1 but is not necessarily an integer. The proportion of values from a data set that will fall within 2 standard deviations of the mean would be calculated using Chebyshev's theorem by 1 minus 1 over k squared, where we're given, we have 2 standard deviations, so that we plug that in for k, we square that, 1 minus 1 fourth is 3 fourths, or 75%. So Chebyshev tells us that if we start in the middle with our mean, and we add 2 standard deviations worth of our data, and subtract 2 standard deviations, then 75% of all the data we collected would fall within those values. The various values for k can be substituted in the formula to find the percent of data that would fall within k standard deviations of the range. Two examples that we're going to use to demonstrate the use of Chebyshev's theorem are on this particular slide. The first example says the mean price of houses in a certain neighborhood is $50,000 and the standard deviation is $10,000. We're to find the price range for which at least 75% of the houses will fall. Well, we've already determined that 75% is the proportion values that are plus or minus 2 standard deviations away from the mean. And so we're going to take this 2 and multiply it by what our standard deviation is worth in this particular problem, which is $10,000, and get $20,000. This value then is subtracted from the mean and added to the mean. So when we subtract $20,000 from $50,000, we get $30,000. If we do $50,000 plus $20,000, we get $70,000. Therefore, at least 75% of all the homes sold in the area will have a price range between $30,000 and $70,000. A second example says a survey of local companies found that the mean amount of travel expenses allowances for executives was 25 cents per mile. The standard deviation was 2 cents. Using Chebyshev's theorem, find the minimum percentage of the data values that will fall between 20 cents and 30 cents. So we want to know how many local companies did their average travel allowance for their executives fall between 20 and 30 cents. The three steps involved in this particular calculation. The first step says subtract the mean from the larger value that we were given in our range. So 30 cents is our highest value. We're going to subtract our mean of 25 cents and get 5 cents. Step 2 says divide this difference by the standard deviation to get k. So our difference, 5 cents, divided by the standard deviation, which we were given in the problem, 2 cents, gives us a k value of 2.5. Then in step 3, we're going to substitute this in Chebyshev's theorem to find the percentage. So 1 minus 1 over k squared, for this problem would be 1 minus 1 over 2.5 squared, because we found k to be 2.5. When we work all of that out, then we get 0.84, and that gives us 84%. Therefore, at least 84% of the data values will fall between 20 cents and 30 cents. We said that Chebyshev's theorem applies to any distribution regardless of its shape. However, if we happen to have a bell-shaped or symmetrical or normal distribution curve, which we'll talk about much later in the year, then we can use the empirical rule. So this one is introduced here. The empirical rule says if we go out one standard deviation from the mean, which means you know what your mean is, and you add a standard deviation and subtract the standard deviation, then the percent of values that would fall in that particular range is 68%. If you go within two standard deviations, plus or minus two standard deviations, then all of that range of values would include 95% of our data. If you go out three standard deviations from the mean, minus three, plus three, then that data would fall in the, all that data that would fall in this area would be 99.7% of our total data that we collected.